Problem number 7. A synchronous motor is receiving 10 megawatt of power at 0.8 power factor lagging at 6 kilovolt. An LG fault occurs at the middle point of the transmission line as shown in the network below. Find the fault current. The ratings of generator, motor and transformer are given below. And the power system network is also given below. So this is a given power system network having one generator, a motor, two transformers and a transmission line in between the two transformers. The given reactances are in per unit and all the power system components are not on the same ratings. So we have to convert the given per unit values into new per unit values by selecting a common base. So let us consider generator ratings as the common base. Okay, so MVAB 20, KVB 11. So section 1 is the generator section. So based on the transformer, we divide the transmission network into three sections. So in section 1, generator ratings are chosen as the common base. Now in section 2, MVAB remains the same 20, KVB is equal to section 1 KV into transformation ratio of T1, which is 33 kilovolt. In section 3, MVAB is 20, KVB is section 2 KV into the transformation ratio of T2. So we got a 6.6 KV in section 3. So now using the new base values in various sections, you have to convert the given per unit values of the reactances into the new per unit value using the formula X per unit new is equal to X per unit old into MVAB by MVAB old into KVB old square by KVB new square. Since the generator rating is chosen as the common base, there will not be any change in the per unit value of the reactances of generator. So X1, X2, X0 will be same as the old values. For transformer T1, positive, negative and zero sequence reactances are the same, which is old value into new MVAB by old MVAB into old by new KVB square. I have written with respect to the primary side, we got it as J.121 per unit. So for transformer 2, all the three sequence reactances will be the same and it is calculated as J.146 per unit. For the transmission line, the sequence reactances are given in actual units ohm. So convert it into per unit. So for that, we need to calculate the base reactance. So base reactance is equal to KVB square by MVAB. So transmission line is section 2. So 33 square by 20, which is 54.45 ohm. So for the transmission line, positive and negative sequence reactants are equal. So the X1 and X2 in per unit is actual into actual divided by base, which is J.092 per unit. Zero sequence reactants in per unit is equal to X0 actual by X base, which is 10 ohm by 54.45. We got just J.184 per unit. For the motor, X1 is J.292 per unit and X2 equals X0 is equal to J.146 per unit. Next step is to draw the positive, negative and zero sequence networks. So for drawing the sequence networks, we divide the transmission line reactances into two sections because the fault occurs exactly at the midpoint of the transmission line. So X1 is equal to X2 is 0.092 by 2, which is J.046, and X0 is J.092 per unit. So now draw the positive sequence network. EG of the generator, X1 of generator, X1 of transformer 1, X1 by 2 of transmission line, X1 by 2 of transmission line, X1 of transformer 2, X1 of motor. This is EM of the motor. Okay, so where X1 represent the positive sequence reactances. So after drawing the positive sequence network, we have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent positive sequence network. for which we have to calculate the Thevenin's voltage or the pre-fault voltage at the fault terminals, as well as the Thevenin's equivalent positive sequence impedance. Okay, so let's see how to calculate the pre-fault voltage at the fault terminals. And the type of fault is single line to ground fault. So we are shorting the line with respect to the reference ground. Okay, and the voltage at the fault point before occurrence of fault, before the occurrence of fault, is VPF. Okay, so I have marked with red line. And VM is the voltage across the motor terminals. Okay, so now to write VPF, we apply KVL for this particular loop. So VPF is equal to VM plus IM into the impedances J.046 plus J.146. Okay, so for that we need to calculate IM as well as VM. So let us see how to calculate IM. So what is IM? It is the actual current drawn by the motor. So in the beginning, they have given the motor draws 20 megawatt at 0.8 power factor lagging at 6 kilovolt. So the 10 megawatt, 6 kilovolt is the actual rating. Okay. So the actual current drawn by the motor should be calculated based on the actual power drawn. So from the three phase power formula, we have P is equal to root 3 into VLIL cos phi. So we write IM is equal to PM by root 3 V cos phi, where V is the line voltage. And what is P? 10 megawatt. V is 6 kilovolt. Power factor is 0.8. So we got the magnitude of IM as 1202.8 amperes. Given the power factor is 0.8 lagging, which means the current drawn by the motor lags the motor voltage by an angle cos inverse of 0.8. Okay. So in complex form, we write IM as IM is equal to magnitude of IM angle minus phi, since it is lagging. So minus cos inverse of 0.8, which is 1202.8 angle minus 36.87 degree amperes. So to find IM, the actual current drawn by the motor in per unit, we want the actual value by base value of the motor. Okay, so the base value of the current, motor current, IM base is equal to 1000 MVAB by root 3 KVB. It is the base value of the motor current. So motor comes in section 3. So section 3 MVA is 20 and section 3 KVB is 6.6. So we got IM base is 1749.6 amperes. Now calculate IM in per unit. We got it as 0.687 angle minus 36.87 degree per unit. Okay. In the same way, find VM in per unit. VM in per unit is equal to VM actual by VM base. So what is the actual voltage of the motor? 6 kV. So what is the base value of the motor? Base voltage in section 3, 6.6 kV. Okay. So VM is 0.909 angle 0 degree per unit. So pre-fault voltage VPF is equal to VM plus IM into J.046 plus J.146, which is 0.994 angle 6.1 degree per unit. Listen here, in the previous problems, we have dealt with unloaded power system network or generator, so for which VPF has to be assumed as 1 angle 0 per unit, only for unloaded case. Okay, or if they had given us assume or neglect the pre-fault current is 0, we take VPF as 1 angle 0. But here, the actual current drawn by the motor is given. Okay, so you have to calculate the pre-fault voltage. So VPF is calculated. Now we want Z1 equivalent for drawing the Thevenin's equivalent positive sequence network. So from the positive sequence network, short the voltage source and write down the equivalent impedance. Okay, so on either side of the fault, we have the series combination of three reactances in parallel with the series combination of three more reactances. So when you calculate, you will get Z1 equivalent as 0.208 per unit. Now draw the Thevenin's equivalent positive sequence network. VPF in series with Z1 equivalent. These two we have calculated in the previous step. So now draw the negative sequence network. So negative sequence network does not include the voltage sources. Short the voltage sources. Okay. So the X2 negative sequence reactances of all the components are copied down. The new per unit value of the negative sequence reactances X2 of all the components should be written here. Now calculate the Thevenin's equivalent negative sequence impedance. This 3 will be in parallel with the series combination of this 3. So we got Z2 equivalent as J.149 per unit. So now draw the Thevenin's equivalent negative sequence network. It consists of only Z2 equivalent. Coming to the zero sequence network. So zero sequence network, it's drawn by considering the X0, new per unit values of the zero sequence reactances of all the components. Okay, so new per unit zero sequence reactances should be copied on. And note the configuration of the transformer as well as the grounding of the generator as well as motor start point. So we have seen the either sides of the transformer, of both the transformers as well as the machine, neutral or solidly grounded. So we have closed this series switch here. Okay, there is no delta configuration, so we have closed it. So now we have the equivalent impedance, Z0 equivalent as J.172. So series combination of these three in parallel with the series combination of these three. So we got it as J.172 per unit. So the Thevenin's equivalent zero sequence network consists of only Z0 equivalent as shown in this diagram. Now in the problem they have asked to calculate the fault current only for LG fault. So in the case of an LG fault, we connect the positive Thevenin's equivalent positive sequence network, Thevenin's equivalent negative sequence network, Thevenin's equivalent zero sequence network, all three in series. Okay, and the equivalent impedances are written. And we take the usual formula, IA1 is equal to VPF by Z1 plus Z2 plus Z0. Okay, Z1 equivalent plus Z2 equivalent plus Z0 equivalent. Substitute, calculate, we got it as 1.88 at an angle minus 83.9 degrees per unit. Magnitude of fault current, IF is nothing but 3 into magnitude of IA1, which is 5.64 per unit. So since the actual ratings of the components are known, we can calculate the fault current in actual units. So fault current in actual units ampere is equal to per unit value into base value. Okay. So while considering the base current value, you should be very careful that which section's base value should be taken. We know the fault is occurring in the transmission line. So for calculating IB, consider the MVAB and KVB in section 2, which is the transmission line section. Okay, MVAB is 20, KVB is 33. So we got IB as 349.92 ampere. So the fault current in ampere is equal to base. So 5.64 into 349.92, we got it as 1973.55 amperes.